El Instituto Interamericano de Cooperación para la Agricultura,
Operation for Agriculture, IICA, would like to warmly welcome you to this Home of Agriculture of the Americas, on occasion of the inauguration of the Director General of IICA for the period 2018-2022, Manuel Otero. We greet the members of the head table, Mr. Néstor Méndez, Assistant Secretary General of the Organization of American States, OAS, Mr. Vinicio Cerezo Arevalo, Secretary General of the Central American Cooperation System, SICA, Mr. Manuel González Sanz, Minister of Foreign Affairs and Cult of Costa Rica, Mr. Luis Felipe Arauz Cavallini, Minister of Agriculture and Livestock of Costa Rica, and acting as Chairman of the Inter-American Board on Agriculture, Mr. Santiago Hardy, Secretary of Family Agriculture, Coordination and Land Development of the Republic of Argentina, Mr. Mauriano Causino, Ambassador of Argentina to Costa Rica, Alfredo De Angeli, President, the Chairman of Agriculture, Livestock, and Fisheries of the Senate of Argentina, Manuel Otero, Director General of Argentina, Victor Villalobos, Emeritus Director of IICA. Ladies and gentlemen, members of the Supreme Powers of the Republic, excellent heads of the diplomatic corps and of international organizations credited to Costa Rica, emeritus directors of this institute, and officers of IICA, distinguished guests to this solemn event, we very much appreciate your presence today of great relevance to the future of this international organization, and we would like to ask Victor Villalobos, Director Emeritus of IICA, whom completes his mandate today, to address us some words. Dr. Villalobos, please.
Good morning, everyone.
Honorable Manuel González, Minister of Foreign Affairs and Cult, and representative, personal representative of the President of the Republic, Don Luis Guillermo Solís Rivera. I appreciate the kind honor of your presence at this event, and through you, I express my recognition to the kindness of the people of Costa Rica. For 75 years now, one part of its territory has been home to the agricultural and rural community of the Americas. Welcome, may you be. His Excellency, Chairman of the Inter-American Board of Agriculture and Minister of Agriculture and Livestock of Costa Rica, Don Luis Felipe Arauz. Distinguished personalities of the head table that are with us at this solemn event. Director General elect of IICA, Dr. Manuel Otero, honorable members of the diplomatic corps and of international organizations credited to Costa Rica. Dear colleagues from IICA, friends who are with us on this special occasion. It is difficult to speak with so many mixed feelings. In a blink of an eye, 8 years of work have gone by, and although I feel great satisfaction for having done a good job, I cannot cease thinking that I could have done much more and better things. I feel sad attending this phase, the most important in my professional career so far. But I am also pleased to feel to leave the administration of IICA in hands of Dr. Otero, whom I personally appreciate and with whom I share convictions and ideals regarding hemispheric agriculture. Dr. Otero, I am sure that you will know how to lead IICA to a good end And as another Argentinian named Manuel, General Belgrano said, try to propose general means for the advancements of agriculture as the fertile mother that provides all raw materials that drive arts and trade. Just as the renovation of soil and the arrival of rains are necessary for agriculture, the same happens with periodical changes to renew institutions, strengthen its structures, and fill them with new energy to continue with their mission. With that same intention of contributing to build a space of understanding and prosperity for the rural sector in our continent, with which I started my administration as Director General, with that same, I end today. When I began my administration in 2010, I offered to strengthen the technical capacity of the Institute in order to face challenges, present and future, of agriculture in the Americas. At that time, I stated that technical excellence is a virtue that accompanies IICA right from its time of creation. It is precisely what gives value and support to the task of international cooperation it carries out, and therefore is mandatory. Certainly, the economic and social context of these modern times have changed. And although the strongest ravages of the crisis we lived have been overcome, we still face an international view of uncertainty where social and political instability seem to be a constant. Studies reveal that the agricultural sector has had a much better performance over these last few years, although as to economic growth is concerned, it has been difficult to come back to the pace in fighting against poverty, hunger, and inequality, something which affects millions of human beings. Today, the thrust of globalization has been negatively affected by protectionist positions, although we know that building strong and dynamic domestic markets does not depend on setting up barriers, but instead of the efficiency of productive chains inwards and outwards. In this same isolationist trend, the goodness of international cooperation is challenged, which, along with the growing stringency of public resources in the country, leads to doubts on the viabilities of organizations and entities like IICA. Nevertheless, we are still many that are fully convinced that international technical cooperation facilitates the understanding among nations. This is a public good that must be offered to all without any type of conditioning factor, and should be delivered in a timely, efficient, and effective manner. The Institute, which in this year that just ended celebrated 75 years of existence, confirms day after day what I have just said through the work that allows it to encourage, promote, and support the efforts of member states to ensure agricultural development and rural well-being. IICA maintains its position of hemispheric leadership, which it must not lose. The exercise of this leadership has meant a constant adaptation to global, regional, and national contexts in order to respond to the demands and needs of our member states. In this dynamics, it will be Dr. Otero who will need to define the lines of action that will be submitted for approval by the countries. Nevertheless, I I would like to very respectfully express some ideas that he may find useful. Firstly, we need to strengthen the agri-food system. The impact that productive and commercial chains have on the rest of the economy requires to increase productivity and competitiveness through innovation, scientific knowledge, and its application. Secondly, to ensure rural well-being requires to deepen actions to improve the living conditions of rural inhabitants, eradicate poverty, and guarantee food security. Thirdly, we must find a way out the difficulty that markets still face in order to contribute to food security. It will not suffice to produce more if we cannot improve the conditions of access. Fourthly, we should speak about the relationship between agriculture and climate change and the management of natural resources that are vital for the sector, water and soil. And by the way, the new administration will find that the IICA is in the process of being accredited with the Green Fund, and this will lead to great support and drive to technical cooperation in this area. The fifth element has to do with financial fragility, which at this time, and because of the crossroads we are at, the Institute is facing, which will require the full attention of the Director General, the staff at all levels, and above all, the renewed commitment of countries to the organization they themselves have created. I would also like to refer to the urgency to deepen collaboration among cooperation agencies. Fortunately, IICA has a new memorandum of understanding with the FAO, a historical partnership, which, under the terms agreed, shall be a powerful tool in hands of the countries that are members of both entities. And we certainly have to take a great advantage of that. Dear guests, dear colleagues of the Institute, friends all, upon ending my administration, I would like to express my deepest and most sincere appreciation to each and every person that made possible the fulfillment of most of the goals we had set out. To the member states for their trust in me. I have received from each country full support and recognition to the work done by the Institute, and in not few cases, evidence of personal affection, which I very much value and appreciate. To Mexico, my country, built among furrows, cornfields, and corn, the governments of which have provided me support ever since my nomination until the last day of my administration. Truly, thank you. The staff here at the Institute, thank you so much for your dedication and commitment. You are all responsible for ensuring the results we pursue, working with enthusiasm, even in adverse conditions. You people are the one that have allowed the Institute to maintain the standards of quality in technical cooperation. I would like to give each and every one of you a strong hug and embrace, and thank you for having accepted to come along with me over these 8 years under the premise of teamwork as one single IICA. Dr. Otero knows, because he knows you, that he will have to lead a group with exceptional qualifications, both the international professional personnel as well as the local national personnel that works at the headquarters and at the 34 different offices, roll up their sleeves and work in favor of the values and purposes of the Institute. Surely, you will also count on the support of member states, just as I did. because the, working as Director General is the interpretation of the needs, priorities, and mandates of the countries to turn them into concrete actions of cooperation. I cannot go without mentioning my special appreciation to my family, my wife Emilia, who has been permanently coming with me in my dreams, happiness, and long nights, my daughters, sons, and grandchildren that are clear evidence of the example and love of parents. Emilia, thank you so much for your support. Ladies and gentlemen, to vindicate the value of international technical cooperation is part of the nature and origin of IICA. We are emissaries of goodwill, which becomes a reality day by day through the work done on the ground, in the field, and with rural communities. The future of the peoples of the Americas, as has always been, is closely linked to its agriculture. To support it will be crucial to do away with, once and for all, the ghosts of hunger and poverty. The future of hemispheric agriculture will be the future of the Institute. In ending, I reiterate my appreciation to life for having allowed that the dreams of a youth, young student of agronomy from Chapingo become a reality. I end with the hope of turning my legacy into truth with the words of the Texcoco king and poet. What will I take with me? Will I leave nothing of me on earth? How will my should my heart act? Did we come here to live and leave nothing, to sprout nothing on earth? Let us at least leave flowers. Let us at least leave songs. Thank you very much. We thank Dr. Villalobos for his kind words. And now we will hear the remarks of Santiago Hardy, Secretary of Family Farming, Coordination, and Territorial Development of Argentina, who will speak on behalf of Mr. Luis Miguel Echeverry, Minister of Agroindustry of the Republic of Argentina. Mr. Secretary.
Bueno,
well, thank you very much. The truth is, it is a very big honor for me to be here with you today representing Mr. Echeverry. I would like to take advantage of the opportunity to convey his greetings and the greetings of President Mauricio Macri and Minister Echeverry, expressing satisfaction for this new challenge that Manuel Otero will be facing as Director General of IICA. I would like to convey to you the full support of the government of Argentina. For us, it is a tremendous challenge, but also a big opportunity, because we share all the objectives set out by IICA regarding a more competitive, sustainable, and more equitable agriculture. I would like to echo the words just mentioned by the outgoing director. And in his advice to Manuel, I believe that one of the biggest challenges we face today, even the sector I am in, which is in family farming, is this technological revolution that is opening up a big opportunity, particularly to small growers, but for which we must be prepared and we have to work hard. Innovation, technological revolution, and big data will allow family farming and small growers to be much more competitive without ignoring the need to have access to markets. That is the biggest challenge we face. And we believe that on this new occasion, we have to continue to work together with IICA. We will find many of the solutions we require. Once again, I would like to express to all of you the challenge that President Macri has set out to fight poverty and the need for agricultural development and production. That is why each one of us from our own position have to strongly support Manuel Otero in his new challenge he is beginning. I wanted to share that with you. We are also very happy. Once again, Manuel, you can count on all our support to work in these challenges set out by IICA. Thank you all very much. It is an honor to be here with you. Thank you. We thank the Secretary for his kind words of support for the Director General. We will now hear, on behalf of the President of the Republic of Argentina, Mauricio Macri, we will hear the words of his Ambassador to Costa Rica, Mariano Causino. Your Excellency, please. Good morning, everyone. Thank you very much, Mr. Minister of Foreign Affairs, Minister of Agriculture, outgoing director of this institution, Victor Villalobos, our dear fellow citizen, friend, dear friend, Manuel Otero, new director general, Senator De Angeli, chairman of the Division of Agriculture and Fisheries, Secretary of Agriculture, Santiago Hardy, Acting Secretary, Assistant Secretary, and President Cerezo. I would also highlight the presence of another Argentinian citizen here, Dr. Martin Piñeiro, who is Director Emeritus of this director, and he was Director also of this home. Allow me to share these words on behalf of the government of Argentina, President Macri, and the Minister of Foreign Affairs, who has been unable to join us. For Argentina, it is a great honor to see a person like Manuel Otero, having been elected director of this institute of cooperation for cooperation in agriculture. We believe this is a big achievement, the result of a policy being driven by the government of Argentina for the reinsertion of agriculture in the world. For a long time, no Argentinian citizen had reached such a high position like this, and we congratulate you. We would like to thank the member states of IICA and of the Inter-American system for their support to appoint Manuel Otero to head the organization from 2018 through 2022, understanding the relevance of agriculture and cooperation in this field for our country, and our permanent commitment to strengthen mechanisms of hemispheric cooperation. We fully support strong relationships, and we contribute to a strong structure to support inclusive and sustainable development. Argentina decided to propose an agenda of global relevance with a new approach focused on the priorities and needs of the world, of the developing world and of the hemisphere particularly. IICA, as a specialized organization of the Inter-American system, plays a fundamental role as a platform for cooperation based on best agricultural practices to face the problems that limit agricultural development in the region. Our government has proposed to reduce poverty in all its dimensions, and it can only share with great emphasis the vision of IICA of reaching Inter-American agriculture, which is competitive, inclusive, and sustainable, that will allow to feed not only the region, but also a good part of the world. For this reason, we appreciate the efforts of this organization to push the agriculture and food security. We trust the work Manuel Otero will do to support the efforts of member states to ensure rural development. And we wish the new director an outstanding administration. We are certain he will ensure he will work hard to reach the objectives of the Institute. Mr. Minister of Foreign Affairs, you know I will be ending my function here in Costa Rica. It has been an honor for me. And to end, and in a few days I will be leaving, but to end my work through this activity today makes me very happy. And I know that Manuel Otero, aside from being a brilliant director for this entity, will be an outstanding representative of all Argentinians. Thank you all very much. Let us now stand, please, to welcome the President of the Republic of Costa Rica. Good morning, everyone. We would appreciate if you remain standing for the national anthem of the Republic of Argentina and the national anthem of Costa Rica as a host country, while we warmly welcome the President of the Republic of Costa Rica, Luis Guillermo Solís Rivera. We will begin with the national anthem of Costa Rica, followed by the national anthem of Argentina.
Thank you.
You may be seated. We will now proceed to the swearing in of Mr. Manuel Otero as Director General of IICA. This formal ceremony will be headed by the Minister of Agriculture and Livestock of Costa Rica, Luis Felipe Arauz Cavallini, President of the Inter-American Board of Agriculture. We would appreciate if the President of IABA comes to the head table. Mr. Otero will be accompanied by his grandchildren.
Señor
Manuel Rodolfo Otero, please raise your right hand. Based on Resolution 512 issued in the city of San Jose on October 26, 2017, during the 19th ordinary meeting of the Inter-American Board of Agriculture, where you were appointed as Director General of the Inter-American Institute of Cooperation and Agriculture for the of 2018 through 2022, when you were given the general power of attorney as of today, January 15, 2018. Do you swear to truthfully and loyalty and with great awareness perform the duties of Director General according to the nature, purposes, and interests and regulations of this institute? Yes, I do. I swear. If so, may God help you. Otherwise, may God, the member states of the Inter-American Board of Agriculture, will claim you, therefore. Thank you. We will now sign the document with the swearing in. Thank you for this event, and we would welcome the words of Mr. Manuel Otero, Director General of IICA for the period 2018 through 2022.
Señor Presidente,
Excellent President of the dear Republic of Costa Rica, Luis Guillermo Solís, His Excellency Manuel González, Minister of Agriculture, Luis Felipe Raus, President of IABA. My dear fellow citizens, Senator Alfredo Giangeli, President of the Commission of Agriculture of the Senate of the Republic of Argentina, Secretary of Family, Agriculture Coordination and Land Coordination of Santiago Hardy, dear friend Ambassador Mariano Causino, dear Director Emeritus Victor Villalobos, Secretary General of SICA Vinicio Cerezos, Assistant Secretary General of OAS Ernesto Mendez, Director Emeritus Martin Piñero, and Mr. Bradway, distinguished special guests, distinguished representatives of the Diplomatic Corps, dear colleagues from IICA, dear family, my wife, my daughters, my granddaughters. This January 15, 2018 is a day of great excitement and commitment. For this reason, I would like to begin expressing some appreciation, first to the government of President Mauricio Macri, particularly the ministers of foreign affairs and agro-industry of my country, whom I thank for their support to my nomination to head this organization, which expresses the sincere willingness of Argentina in favor of full and deep integration with the countries of the Americas. I also thank the support given by the countries during my election, and I express my respect to the Sister Republic of Chile for the nobility expressed throughout the whole process that ended last October 26th. With the election of the 11th Director General in the history of IICA. Somehow, concretely, on this date, a dream comes true, coming back for a third time to this country, which I consider my home. It happens frequently, but when I came here for the first time, Mr. President, I came here to study at Gautier, an institution which I dearly love, and that gave me an opportunity to become a specialist, as I sought, and that led me to leave Buenos Aires to come and settle here in Turrialba, in the heart of the tropical Americas. In this country, I spent about one-third of my professional life, and obviously its beauty, its culture, its idiosyncrasy, and above all, the kindness and warmth of its people are always present in my family. They are part thereof. Maria de Los Angeles, my oldest daughter, who is with us today, carries that name because of the virgin, the patron saint of this beautiful country that my wife and I love so much. Now, at a more intimate level, I would like to highlight the importance of Costa Rica in my life, both my personal life as well as my professional life, involved in tasks that come together for the raison d'etre of a beautiful organization, a dear organization, the foundation and mission of which needs to be reposed in the continental and international context, an institution which, after 75 years of history, has strived to maintain unaltered its historical mandate, which is nothing but to support the efforts of member states to ensure the development of agriculture and rural well-being through technical cooperation of excellence. I would also like to say that part of my baggage is the legacy of the latest directors general of this institution, because I've had the privilege of working with four of them, Martin Piñeiro, Carlos Aquino, Chelston Bradwith, and Victor Villalobos. I stop here to express special appreciation to Dr. Piñeiro, whom invited me in 1988 to join IICA, as well as Dr. Victor Villalobos for his leadership facing this institution during this last period and the warm treatment given to me. Allow me to clarify also my appreciation to Dr. Bradwith. I had taken a sabbatical for 3 years. Dr. Bradwith invited me to return to IICA, and I am very grateful for that. The world is attempting to solve many crises today, all of those of an anthropogenic nature, which continue a condition of sustainable future. I will refer to the most important one, the food crisis and its nutritional consequences, and the population crises, energy and environmental crises. All of these have a common denominator, agriculture. A rigid and biased vision puts our sector as part of the problem. But right from within IICA, we have the duty and responsibility to work to demonstrate that agriculture is, above everything else, an inseparable part of the solution to this threatening reality. Precisely recognizing the central role of agriculture in the global agenda is why IICA is facing a big opportunity to exercise a renewed protagonism in the next 25 years. An additional agenda of our Americas show that exports represent 13% of global agricultural trade and 1/3 of our net exports. Based on our enviable endowment of natural resources and based on the projections for an increase in demand, our continent is a fundamental guarantor, not only of food and nutritional security worldwide, but also of the environmental sustainability of the planet. This is a protagonism and a responsibility we need to accept at all dimensions. To capitalize it forces us to repose traditional visions regarding agriculture in the continent. We must leave behind that conservative and pessimistic vision, basically limited to that of a mere provider of raw materials for the global value chains. Instead, we need to turn our America into a big factory of processed foods, bioenergy, probiotics, nutraceuticals, and biomaterials. This, in summary, is the smart industrialization based on biological resources, which, with the support of science and technology, can promote a greater sectoral diversity, international competitiveness, and generation of employment, simultaneously contributing to the mitigation of climate change. Bioeconomy expresses a good measure this transforming vision to promote sustainable and smart production based on the natural resources we have. From IICA, we will focus our efforts to overcome this old-fashioned vision of the agricultural sector as of extraction and generation of primary goods, and instead see agriculture as the industry of biomass and a central protagonist of new times in societies that aspire to be less dependent on fossil resources and work instead towards climatically responsible productive strategies. This paradigm shift poses a new protagonism of rural territories, which must be seen as areas of progress with new technologies and connectivity, reverting the current vision that limits them to be generators of poverty and expelling human resources. This scenario poses a new opportunity for 15 million small growers in the hemisphere distributed among 400 million hectares, which historically have been the variable of adjustment in the dynamic of productive processes, the viability of which is ever more conditioned due to the consequences of climate change. No institutional frameworks for a more productive, inclusive, and resilient agriculture with the active participation of youth and women are possible and must be the direction our efforts take. We are in a world that is concerned and worried about the deterioration of natural resources and climate change, where business as usual has ceased to be an option. And therefore, it is imperative to modify strategies and behaviors to produce more and better. We have everything that is missing to go down that path. It would be unforgivable to waste this opportunity. We are a young continent, social, politically, and culturally diverse, ever more committed to democracy as a political system, and with a past, a present, and a future intimately linked to agriculture. We cannot allow inequality, delays, and exclusion. These words must be eliminated from our jargon, and I would like to commit IICA to this process. Within our organization, many large exporters of food products coexist that work with countries that still face the scourge of food insecurity. This heterogeneity is seen as a capital and not as a restriction to work jointly. We need to recognize the productive scale with an offering that covers a large range of products from temperate regions and tropical regions. And based on this, we need to build new schemes of assistance and cooperation. All these changes pose the inexorable end of a model of technical cooperation that arose in the 1950s. That model, supported on the guiding principle of technical assistance, sought to build capacity for the design and implementation of policies to address the requirements and limitations of countries and institutions. A new model arises today, the base of which, no doubt, is the success of the past, but that should also address the challenges of new demands of cooperation. The outstanding characteristics of this new paradigm must be efficiency, flexibility, decentralization, collaborative work, insertion into networks, focus on processes, and the mobilization of institutional and human resources. The rigid content of countries that offer and demand cooperation disappears, and we see the new collective construction of knowledge, the central paradigm of new cooperation, supported on a fruitful an uninterrupted trajectory over 75 years, IICA should project itself and build a new future in benefit of the actors and institutions of the agri-food systems of the Americas. The path towards its centennial will carry IICA to consolidate as a resource, a strategic resource in at the service of countries, making substantive contributions for the transformation of agriculture in our continent. Now, what is the IICA I dream with and that we will attempt to build with the decisive support of member countries? I dream with a less bureaucratic IICA, much more efficient, providing technological cooperation of excellence to remove the obstacles that limit the transformation of agriculture in our continent. I dream of an IICA where the government entities are updated that promote overcoming the obstacles to cooperation and create the conditions for the active participation of the private sector, spinal column of the development of agriculture. I dream of IICA focused on the problems that need to be solved through technical cooperation that is based on the more pressing and relevant issues like climate change, trade and health, innovation and development, bioeconomy and chains, and family agriculture and territories. I dream with an IICA which is more solidary and acting on the hurdles that are to development in our continent, particularly Central America and the Caribbean, with differentiated strategies that empower the countries to seek innovative solutions. I dream with an IICA that can become consolidated as a network of networks, acting as a true organizer, a mover, and a driver of all those collective environments that address agriculture and its future. I dream of an IICA that consolidates a red network that promotes aggressive strategy to capture external resources to better serve our countries. I dream an IICA that reinforces its commitment to bodies of integration, sub-regional and regional, providing a portfolio of supranational projects focused on solving shared issues. At this time, I express my appreciation to Dr. Vinicio Cerezo, Secretary General of the Central American Integration System and a former president of Guatemala, for his presence today. And I reiterate the importance of the partnership we will implement with SICA. I extend my recognition in favor of the role of the Caribbean Community, CARICOM, and the Organization of Eastern Caribbean States, or OECS, and the Andean Community of Nations. I also highlight the importance of Canada, the United States, and Mexico, and of course, the Mercosur, that due to its productive and technological profile has great possibilities of building links to supplement the search for a more solidary and united America. in the name of all these mechanisms of integration that are indispensable for, to consolidate democracy in our region and to support the integration of IICA, I greet the presence of the Assistant Secretary General of the OAS, Néstor Méndez, whom I ask to convey our greetings to Luis Almagro, Secretary General, who I am have been united through many years of work in my work in Uruguay. If I had to summarize the work of IICA in one image, it would be a bridge to unite nations, regions, Latin America and the Caribbean, North and South, issues, links with other international organizations and civil society, where we can develop a new solidarity within our own continent. I wonder, why are we the region in the world with the lowest levels of intra-bloc trade? Why are we a continent with such high levels of violence, exclusion, and inequality? From IICA, and through Cooperation for Agriculture, I reiterate to all of you my commitment to undertake a coordinated action that will continue to revert these problems. I will work hard to project IICA towards the next 25 years on its path towards centennial. For this, I will require the active support of the Ministers of Agriculture and the Ministries of Foreign Affairs of our countries to drive this new effort to turn its demands and guidelines into mandates. You are our constituents. To the officers of IICA, I ask for an additional effort for the so that with their support and dedication, you can be part protagonists in the construction of this strongest institution. To my family, especially Vicky, my wife, I apologize if because of my due responsibilities at this institution, I ignore some of my family commitments. I quote Jean Monnet, father of European integration, and a phrase that summarizes the spirit of my desire to find a renovated IICA for all and for everyone. Nothing happens without human beings, and nothing prevails without institutions. Thank you very much. We very much thank Mr. Otero for his first words as Director General of IICA. And as first action, we will sign a programmatic political declaration within the strategic part, an innovative partnership, IICA-SICA 2018-2022, the main objective of which will be to promote the partnership of a new development partnership of agriculture and rural nature in a sustainable social and economic spiritual focus at the service of individuals, facilitating employment undertakings and security in the framework of Central American integration. This is a priority of IICA to support the social, economic, and security agenda through this instrument, through the enforcement in the territories and rural communities of the SICA countries. In this sense, we offer the floor to Mr. Vinicio Cerezo Alevaro, Secretary General of the Central American Integration System. Your Excellency. Distinguished and respected President Luis Guillermo Solís, Distinguished Minister of Foreign Affairs, dear authorities of the Republic of Costa Rica, representatives of the governments of Argentina, and of course, distinguished, dear, and admired Directors Emeritus of IICA, dear Manuel. Good morning. Friends all, very respectfully, I would like to convey a feeling with you. This is a very special day for the Secretary General of IICA. With Manuel Otero, I should call him Don Manuel Otero. Allow me to just call him Manuel, whom today becomes the head of the IICA. We have decided to establish a partnership in line with the historical process in the Central American region. The modern milestone of which is the Esquipulas peace process, found in Guatemala on August 7, 2087, at a transcendental point in time to strengthen peace, democracy, and the renewed strengthening of Central Americans to ensure Central American integration through a collective effort and in consistency with this SICA-IICA partnership. And since we share essential ethical values and principles, a humanist vision where people are the protagonists of development processes, and the respect for human rights, the participation of women and youth, and of originary nations, as well as the recognition to human rights, to adaptation, and particularly of the more vulnerable groups in our region. We also share the principle that the state, the economy, the integration systems, and international cooperation must be aimed at strengthening the living conditions of the population at large. We see public policy, rural economy, and agriculture interacting and serving people, the human beings that live and work in the territories and rural communities of the countries within the Central American integration system in the Caribbean, the continent, and in fact, in the whole planet. We coincide with the fact that Central America is one of the most vulnerable regions in the world to climate change and to all social and economic problems we have been unable to solve. Therefore, we reflect the spiritual words of Father Francis, where he says that the ecological proposal is always social and ecology is also human. We make our own the commitment of supporting our people for the effective implementation. For the effective implementation of the commitments of the Agenda 2020-2030 of the United Nations and the 17 Sustainable Development Goals, the commitments of the Paris Agreement, which have become the objective of survival, in fact, for human beings, and which have been supported and proposed as a priority by the Central American presence. We would like to help transform our region, enabling a resilient agriculture and a rural environment resilient to climate change in search of to overcome economic, social, and human inequality through adaptation and mitigation measures and reducing the vulnerability to the devastating impacts of climate change. In this sense, we Central Americans can be victims of this climate change. But we want to instead be activists, allies, to face it and become more resilient to changes it may cause. The programmatic benchmarks of this partnership are supported in our historical documents, pointed out in the document we are signing, but especially in the IICA Convention, the Tegucigalpa Protocol, the strategic regional agenda prioritized by the Summit of SICA Presidents, the Central American Partnership for Sustainable Development, the Sustainable Development Goals 2030, and the Paris Agreement on Climate Change. And we decided to assume the conduction of strengthening the regional integration process so that together we can face the challenges set out at this time by history. The Secretary General of SICA will strengthen this coordination through the Secretariat of the system and with all the institutions of relevant integration to ensure the sustainable goals by coordinated efforts made by the Central American countries and the Caribbean countries to face the problems we are facing. Our objective in this partnership is to promote a new sustainable development model, as Manuel Otero has said, developing rural nature and agriculture and an extended sustainable social, economic, and political vision at the service of people, facilitating employment undertakings in the framework of strengthening the integration process in Central America, where IICA is a priority to support the economic, social, and security agenda in the face of this new declaration that will apply to all countries of IICA. In summary, we have proposed to work on four fundamental axes, which are to promote local governance and human security of families in rural communities, to live and work respecting the human condition, particularly that of the more vulnerable groups, to turn sustainability, the care for the environment and sustainable development into our own priorities and enable this to be so for other international cooperation agencies and multilateral banking system. We will work on the training and development of capacities in local governments, particularly among youth and women in rural communities. And we will strengthen and develop the rural productive sector, further enabling its participation in regional policies, in value-added processes, access to national and international trade, promoting programs to improve productivity and economic competitiveness with social equality. I am certain that this partnership will mark a before and an after in rural development in our region. Through the best of our will, we will ensure that other organizations join this effort and share a common agenda that will allow us to show as soon as possible the good examples of sustainability in rural areas and progressive well-being and the security of inhabitants in the region. We can count on you, and may this be so. Thank you very much. We proceed now to the signature of the document that President Cerezo was just referring to.
An applause, please.
Now we will hear the words of Mr. Nestor Mendez, Assistant Secretary General of the Organization of American States. Mr. Ambassador, please.
Muy buenas tardes a todos.
Good afternoon, everyone. Excelentísimo señor Honorable Luis Guillermo Solís, President of the Republic of Costa Rica. His Excellency Manuel González, Minister of Foreign Affairs and Cult, distinguished authorities of Argentina, other authorities of Costa Rica, my dear friend, Victor Villalobos, Director General Emeritus, Dr. Manuel Otero, incoming Director General of IICA, ladies and gentlemen, for me, it is a true honor to participate at this ceremony where we are welcoming Manuel Otero as new Director General of IICA. I am a Central American. I am from Belize. And every opportunity I have to come to Central America is always a great pleasure for me. Additionally, these days are especially pleasurable because of the cold in Washington. A couple of days I can sneak out to the Central American warmth is always a pleasure. Allow me to convey, first of all, on behalf of the Secretary General Luis Almagro, his apologies for having been unable to attend. Due to agenda reasons, he was unable to come to Costa Rica. But he asked me to please express his congratulations to Mr. Otero on assuming this office, which is so important for the region, as well as our appreciation and congratulations to Victor Villalobos for his leadership throughout these last few years for stellar work done in benefit of all our countries in such an important area as is agriculture.
The OAS and IICA have maintained a close relationship over the years. As the hemisphere's foremost body on agriculture in the Inter-American system, IICA has continued to effectively serve the needs of the 34 member states of the OAS in the areas of water management, sustainable production chains, renewable energy, food security, and agriculture resiliency, just to name a few. Today, our region faces myriad challenges in the agricultural sector, ranging from lack of physical infrastructure and value added, high energy costs, low and sustainable production, and most importantly, the impacts of climate change. Colder winters, warmer summers, longer droughts, and rising sea temperatures have wreaked havoc on agriculture production and exportation. Agriculture is the backbone of many of our societies and a principal engine of economic growth. Globally, our region accounts for 23% of arable land, 31% of water, and 23% of forest cover, and represents 13% of agricultural trade. It is estimated that by 2050, the planet's population will rise to 9.7 billion from 7.3 billion today, forcing agriculture production to increase by 70% in order to meet food demands. This is an issue of global proportions that requires global action. For that reason, it is imperative that multilateral organizations such as IICA, the OAS, the United Nations, and others work collaboratively to design programs and implement measures that will redound to the benefit of sectors of society, in particular women, youth, and other groups in vulnerable situations. The Organization of American States addresses a wide cross-section of issues in human rights, in democracy, multidimensional security, and integral development, and recognizes their equal value and undeniable link. There can be no democracy without development, no development in the absence of human rights, and full rights are unattainable amidst insecurity and instability. Agriculture, the foundation of many of our countries, is also inextricably linked to each of these themes. Our efforts to address its challenges must be pragmatic and systematic, and engender an agricultural sector that is productive, sustainable, resilient, and inclusive. We must also find ways to make agriculture attractive once again to youth and women by optimizing opportunities for employment across the region and the creation of avenues for broader participation, including through education, technology, and innovation. In many of our countries, young people comprise the majority of our populations. We must harness the power of our youth. Not only are they our future, they are very much our present. One way that the OAS has sought to empower youth is through the highly successful Small Business Development Centers program, which was launched in 2012 in the Caribbean. These centers provide advisory and training services to entrepreneurs in sourcing capital, business plan development, marketing and sales, and product development. Using the public-private partnership model, the Small Business Development Centers combines the resources of institutions of higher learning with the public and private sector to create jobs and economic opportunities across all sectors, including agriculture. The program has also been extended to countries in Central America. Furthermore, in 2013, the OAS signed a memorandum of understanding with IICA to offer online academic programs in agro-ecotourism, the latest of which was opened in February 2017 through the Education Portal of the Americas, and was aimed at small and medium-scale farms. Course content included assistance in business planning for agro-ecotourism, training on tourism in rural areas, tourism marketing, and organization design. Developing countries in particular that rely heavily on agricultural production require immediate attention. For example, the government of Haiti has prioritized agriculture in its national development plan as a way to boost the economy, to reduce poverty, and to create jobs. By way of its strategy on Haiti, IICA has maintained a strong presence on the island by rendering support to the government in strengthening institutional capacity, implementing reforestation projects, offering technical assistance to rural farmers in improving infrastructure and watershed management, and accessing capital and agricultural insurance. As our region continues to grapple with issues of inequality, poverty, and marginalization, we should not see these as insurmountable challenges, but rather a call to deepen hemispheric cooperation and collaboration. Indeed, the agricultural issues of the hemisphere vary, and our approach must be tailored to the specific needs of each one of our countries. Moreover, we must seek to strengthen strategic alliances, including South-South cooperation, triangular cooperation, and to increase the sharing of information and best practices. Let us never forget that we serve the same constituents, the peoples of the Americas. I conclude by offering personal congratulations to Mr. Otero on your appointment as Director General of IICA. On behalf of the General Secretariat of the OAS, we look forward to working with you and expanding our collaboration with IICA. I also take this opportunity to express thanks to Mr. Villalobos for his work throughout the years and congratulate him on a successful stewardship of this important organization. I wish you all success in your future endeavors. Muchísimas gracias.
Agradecemos también las palabras del señor embajador.
We thank Ambassador Mendez for his kind words. And to end with this event, we offer the floor to Luis Guillermo Solís Rivera, President of the Republic of Costa Rica. Mr. President.
Buenas tardes para
Good
todas,
afternoon, everyone.
Todos, señor ministro,
Mr. Minister of Agriculture and Livestock, Mr. Minister of Foreign Affairs, distinguished Manuel Otero, Director General of the Inter-American Institute of Cooperation for Agriculture, Director Villalobos, Director Emeritus, and all other directors emeritus that are with us, Mr. Secretary, Mr. Ambassador, Mr. Senator, Mr. Assistant Secretary General, Mr. Secretary General of SICA, Honorable and Excellent Ambassadors to the Government of the Republic, Mr. Néstor Méndez, Assistant Secretary General of the OAS, members of the International Board on Agriculture, former Vice Ministers of Foreign Affairs, of Agriculture and Livestock of Costa Rica, officers of IICA, special guests, friends all. First of all, I would like, as has been done by those that spoke before me, to celebrate Manuel Otero as new Director General of this entity. On behalf of the people of Costa Rica and of its government, I join in congratulating him for his new position, and I wish him the best success in this mission, which he is certainly prepared for due to his leadership and knowledge in an area of outstanding relevance for all our countries. Victor Villalobos and all his predecessors, Directors General of this entity, as you were saying, Mr. Director General, officers that have worked with passion and commitment, they have given the best of themselves in favor of agriculture in our continent. I would also like to thank the contribution made by each in due time to strengthen agriculture and its institutions in America. Reference has been made once and again to the importance of IICA in this new phase that is beginning under the wise and prudent mandate of Manuel Otero. And the challenges that this entity, together with others in the hemisphere, have to address the regional agenda. Therefore, I will not refer to those tasks that are very well known by each and every one of you. Instead, I would like to briefly make reference in a heartfelt manner to a concept which is at the core itself of the mission of this entity, and which is part of the institutional mission. It was already mentioned by Don Manuel, certainly. And that is this beautiful concept of rural well-being. I believe that this idea of rural well-being brings together everything we want for an entity like IICA, but beyond that, everything we want for our own governments. And I would even dare say for our own states, the rural well-being. How powerful a concept. Because there, aside from the need for productivity and enable productivity, both in large agricultural enterprises as well as in small family units, we see this idea that agriculture is not just production, it is also people, particularly people that produce. And that is that in the heart of the endeavors of this organization, the priority inevitably is people. And these people that produce, large and small, as is the case of the people that you work with, Mr. Secretary General, in Argentina, that have to do with the generation of food and well-being, understanding this in a very comprehensive term, these must be at the center of all our concerns. What is a policy without people? What is production without those that are the main beneficiaries? In that point of rural well-being, understanding the territorial dimension, the rural environment, which has been lagging in Latin America for so many years, is where challenges will be the biggest. They are not as great as they were in the 19th century when states were fragmented for geopolitical and ideological reasons, but they continue to be set aside today because at times when technology is so strong and linkages have been established that are something never seen before because thanks to technology, even so today. The rural environment is lagging, and the connectivity of those regions continues to be a challenge which sometimes seems impossible to overcome. Ever since the 1940s, there was clarity in IICA in the sense that it was precisely there, in that rural environment, where rural well-being had to continue to be sought. Although there are other territorial challenges today, including those that have to do with urban areas where poverty has basically settled in all our countries of the Americas, both in Latin America as well as in the rest of the countries of this continent, is precisely where challenges continue to be the greatest. Sometimes there is an excessively romantic vision of the rural areas, the countryside, where all you have to do is pull out your hand and pick up some fruit to eat, the countryside where beautiful music is sung, where we see so many of the beautiful images of our national art, and that unfortunately is where there is least health services and least education services, where telecommunication arrives at the latest, where the water for human consumption is filthiest, where the animals they produce for their own well-being is the skinniest, and where they lack that rural well-being that the organization has been called upon to work on. That is why I highlight this powerful idea regarding the origin of this entity, because we should turn our eyes on the rural environment with everything that has to do with the countryside. And of course, this calls for public policies that are not just those where agriculture is involved. This is an opportunity for all other sectors of our states to intervene through legislation, newer legislation with faster justice, prompt justice, with programs that the executive branches in all endeavors can coincide with that rural well-being that, as I mentioned, agriculture is only one part thereof. That is the task that Manuel Otero is going to face with an impressive package of experiences, expertise, and that is where I hope that he experiences his most outstanding successes. This afternoon, we must also celebrate something else, and that is the recognition that Central America as a whole has also a responsibility with its rural environment. And the presence of the Secretary General of IICA at this event and the such important document that was just signed is precisely an expression of that commitment that we need to continue to develop. We, as members of this organization, this regional organization, and I think of this particularly in terms of those that would be the main beneficiaries of a rural well-being policy in Central America, which, just as Latin America, are some of the most lacking and the most needy in our societies, women, youth, indigenous peoples, Afro-descendants, that many of which are guardians of our heritage have unfairly been excluded from development due to a lack of national as well as regional policies. This fortunate coincidence of a multilateral hemispheric proposal with a concern that cannot be ignored by states, particularly because it is up to us governments, particularly the executive branches, to protect those policies, to turn agriculture, livestock, fisheries, another area where it is important to look back and turn those policies into a central part of our reality. This becomes an opportunity for human development. I would like to end by congratulating IICA and its member states, which in the end are not the institutions that out of spontaneous generation lead to leadership, but instead the states for having selected Manuel Otero. And I recognize the goodness of his opposer in this search for the position of Director General, because of everything that you all represent today, the obligation of contributing to the development of a very important part of our reality and our history, which is linked to the countryside. Once again, welcome back to your own country, Don Manuel, you and your family. The state of Costa Rica, not only this administration, which is about to end, to give way to a new administration, will be sure to continue this struggle in favor of people, supporting IICA and its people in all its tasks in the next four-year period. And just as been in the past, there will be generations of administrations coming one after another, supporting the work done by everyone. I wish you all a 2018 full of prosperity and great success. Here, in the heart of the agriculture of this continent, here at this IICA that is so respected and so admired, is where we can build the spaces for coexistence and production that will be such a great benefit to all our brothers and sisters of the continent. Thank you very much. We would like to thank the President of the Republic for his words. We would like to invite you all to go downstairs to join us with a glass of wine, and let us all stand while the members of the head table leave the room. Thank you. Sí, nos va a odiar la gente. Sí.